welcome to our Insight session. My name is Jody Harouche, and I am the Chief Creative Officer and President of Multimedia Plus. Basically, what we offer is an app-based platform that's really meant to communicate to the front line through an exciting, dynamic, and branded interface. So I'm very fortunate to have with me clients, partners that are going to kind of walk us through how they're using this technology to really impact and influence the customer's in-store experience. I would like to introduce you to Pierre Olivier from Tiffany & Company and Emily Schuyler from Kate Spade. So, Emily, let's start with you.
Yeah, let's do it.
So, first question is, how does Kate Spade ensure to deliver a customer-first experience on a consistent basis?
Sure, absolutely. And I'm so excited to be here on behalf of Kate Spade New York in partnership with Multimedia Plus to share our progress and success with this platform. So, you know, for us at Kate Spade, we are first and foremost a customer-centric organization, and that means externally as well as internally. So, we're really lucky because we're such a unique brand, and our brand promise is to empower our girl to lead a more interesting life. And so we want this to permeate externally and internally as well. From our award-winning marketing to how we curate our stores, everything we do is through that customer first lens. And most importantly, we fill our stores with our teams who are passionate brand fans that want to work for us, and they just can't wait to share their love of the brand with their guests. You know, our associates and in our specialty stores, we call them muses because they bring so much to the customer than just an average sales associate. They not only understand, but they're obsessed with showing our guests how special our brand is. And most importantly, we deliver personalized experiences. I think that's the key to driving a customer-first experience, is making it personalized. These days, everybody wants something unique. Everybody wants something that's specialized just for them. And that's exactly what we do.
Excellent. So Emily and her team created a short video for us to kind of talk about how they're utilizing the Insight platform and some of their success.
Hi there, I'm Bree.
And I'm Cassie.
And I'm Emily. And we're the retail training team for the Learning and Development Department at Kate Spade & Company. At Kate Spade & Company, we are a customer-centric organization, both externally and internally, with a focus on delivering a best-in-class guest experience. With that in mind, we believe technology should enhance the guest experience rather than dictate the experience. We offer personalized, high-touch engagement while offering the technology to both our internal and external customer when and where she wants it. Before we began working with Multimedia Plus, we struggled with a lack of learning consistency and understanding if and how our training tools were being used. As a growing company, we needed our teams to speak the same brand and product language and deliver this message to our guests with confidence. As a result of using what we've named the Style Study, we have been able to ensure training consistency, check for compliance and understanding, and importantly, measure performance. Here at Kate Spade & Company, we are quick, curious, playful, and strong. And through the Style Study, the training and communication that we deliver are clever, modern, and relevant, and completely encompass the DNA of our brand. Through this platform, we can easily support our brand promise to inspire our girl to lead an interesting life.
One of the biggest wins is being able to break out training into smaller bite-sized pieces. We know social media has all but eliminated our attention span, so it's been important for us to be able to communicate information that's clear and concise and allows our associates to learn on the fly. The technology is in line with the way our associates want to be communicated with today in a busy retail environment. In retail, payroll is always a concern, and being able to learn in the moment during a slow period on the sales floor using the iPad or right before our team hits the sales floor has been a big win for us. We no longer need to beg for those 2 hours for training sessions each month.
We also love the ability to let the data tell the story of our success.
It helps guide the teams towards opportunities to make them successful and to achieve their goals. It also allows us to celebrate their successes by hearing anecdotal feedback on their overall results. For example, one of our shops in Maryland saw a $20 jump in their average dollar transaction because their associates felt much more confident on the shop floor after going through the style study. Another shop stated that they saw a 21% lift in their handbag sales in quarter one of last year after completing the style study. Needless to say, this platform is a critical part to driving our business forward. Do you agree, ladies?
Yeah, we'd
absolutely.
Say so.
Just to give you a little bit of a glimpse into how Kate Spade in New York is utilizing not only the platform for communicating to associates, but also the data that is on the back end of it to really ensure that they're driving success. So before you had a mobile associate communication platform, which is what we've coined this, how have you been delivering training and communications to your associates?
Yeah, Jody, you know, I think we all ask ourselves this question, what did we do before we had some of this incredible innovative technology that we do now? And it wasn't that long ago, you know, about 5 or 6 years ago, we were a much smaller organization. And we would simply email PDFs to our stores. They would print these training tools and post them in their back rooms. Or even on a quarterly basis, some of our more critical product knowledge, we would print those documents and ship them to each individual store. So, you know, this was sort of the way that everybody had to do things before. Then we moved on to a store intranet that we refer to as ShopTalk, and we continue to use this today. It's an organized communication portal that allows for all corporate and store communications, and this was a huge move on for us to really get that information to stores. However, we feel like it really lends itself to the more operational side of the business rather than the training and leadership that we want to focus on. So we've been faced with a couple major challenges as a department. The first is that we're a rapidly global growing company and business. And our two biggest areas of our growth are focused on product category expansion as well as channel expansion. So when you think that we're growing our products and we're going to be in new categories as well as we want to be in new marketplaces, that's a lot of growth. And so we have to keep asking ourselves, you know, what is the priority? And how do we walk the fine line of educating without inundating our store teams? And how can we ensure that we make an impact that stays focused on these priorities? The second unique challenge is that we rebuilt our selling strategy in our specialty stores in late 2015 that we aptly call the guest journey. And as many retailers were choosing between leaning fully into technology and others holding steadfast into traditional retailing, we redesigned ourselves to deliver a personalized experience, as I mentioned before, that allows technology to enhance rather than dictate her experience. And our job was and still is to provide training that really is changing behaviors and changing a mindset in the store, but that stays aligned with our key metrics.
So it's interesting that you say changing a mindset, because the one thing that I specifically love about Kate Spade's training is the emphasis on the creativity that you deliver to the internal customer. So we all, as associates, have internal customers, right? They love the brand. They want to work for Kate Spade for a reason, Tiffany for a reason. And the level that you communicate is just amazing. And the fact that you use a ton of video also helps create that essence of the brand. So let's take a sneak peek into what their visual training looks like at Kate Spade.
Good morning. I'm Julia. Welcome to Kate Spade, New York. I'm so excited that you're here to spend the day with me, so I can walk you through my most important responsibilities as the visual lead for this store. It's important to look at every detail every morning. This morning is going to be busy. I like to start my to-do list the second I walk in the door, and it's helpful to write everything down to keep track of what I need to get done.
So So I'm sure as you can imagine, if you've come from a retailing background, which I assume most of us have, going through visual training like this wouldn't have been as painful as sitting there going through a document of books trying to figure out what exactly do you want me to do. I'm 22 years old and I've never set a floor set in my life and I don't understand what the difference is. So obviously this level of communication and fun really make it enjoyable. So kind of another quick question for you, Emily, before we move on to Pierre is, how are you gauging success of style study? Because at the end of the day, it's all about numbers, right? We're all here to make our stores more profitable. So what are you doing to gauge this success?
Sure. And, you know, as we talked about in the brief video that opened our session, you know, in Maryland, we saw about a $20 jump in our ADT because the stores felt more confident on the sales floor after going through the style study. So this is a huge, huge jump in a business number just, you know, for one store. And it really is all about confidence. And we believe that the branded experience that we've been able to provide through the style study has really sort of triggered this ultimate change and jump in our business. You know, and we've really seen a steady build in all of our KPIs, sales, conversion, UPT, ADT, you name it, due to this gained confidence and understanding from the platform.
So the other thing that you've been instrumental as a partner is really helping us as a company understand how retailers need this information and what they're looking for. And one of the reports that you helped us create is a push report that now goes to regional and district managers emailed on a weekly basis to tell them what's happening with their stores. And the one thing that we say is visibility equals accountability, and transparency means that no one's hiding behind the I don't know what's going on. So tell us a little bit about the numbers that you see.
Sure, yeah. I mean, we use quizscore.com, of course, to analyze our success on this platform. But Multimedia Plus really heard our need to have an automated channel-focused result snapshot delivered weekly. So not only do we use this on a corporate level to see how we're doing on the platform, but all of the regional directors and district leaders receive these district snapshots on a weekly basis. So even if they forget to log into QuizScore that week, every Monday morning they're going to receive a district snapshot and they will see exactly how their store is doing and an overview, a quick snapshot of their results.
Excellent. So without further ado, we're going to move on to Pierre, who is from Tiffany & Company. And Pierre, you know, your role is similar, but very different. So why don't you give us a little overview of what you bring to Tiffany & Company?
Sure. So I'm part of the global education team. So my role is specifically, I'm a learning systems manager. So my responsibility is really to, I'm responsible for our web presence of all of our training materials. So I manage all of the systems that basically are used to create, deploy, and track our learning content and deploy to the field on a global basis. So we've been using this platform just recently. We implemented it this year, and we're very excited with the results, and I'm happy to be here to share some of those with you.
About Tiffany & Company is the entire organization got behind this launch and created an internal marketing piece about how excited they were to offer this to their sales professionals. So we have the actual video that went out to support the launch.
There will be a number of new apps on the iPads, one of which that we are particularly excited about is one called 57th and 5th, and that will be going live next week.
This app will bring communications and training right to the sales professional management team over the iPad. You can take the training anytime and anywhere in the store. Pretty fantastic.
57th and 5th will offer our communications directly to basically everyone in the store, not just store management, but also sales professionals, operations professionals, everyone. The Northern is a weekly newsletter that conveys all things sales related.
And using this app, we'll be able to send it directly to sales professionals and everyone else in the store.
The app is tailored to you based on your role, so all you have to do is log into the app. It is so important to us that we support you in your ongoing professional development. This 57th and 5th app, with its mobility, its flexibility, its ability to be accessed anywhere in the store at any time, will really help you in doing that.
So pretty cool in order to launch a to be able to go out with a video like that to ensure that it's being used. So when we talk about Tiffany & Company being the global organization of 300-plus stores that you are today, historically, what were some of the challenges that you had prior to using 57th and 5th?
So as you can imagine, in order for us to communicate with such a wide range of sales professionals across the world, we have a lot of departments in Tiffany that want to communicate to this audience. And they were doing it sort of individually, so they were sending out emails, they were sending out PDFs, as Emily was referring to. There would be in-store communications, and they were not all necessarily consistent. So there were some who would lack, the frequency was an issue, so at some point the store directors were getting like 200 emails went into different topics in 1 month. So they didn't really know where to focus or what was important. They were inconsistent in that they weren't branded in a particular way. And then there was a sense of hierarchy, really understanding what is really important, what we should be focusing on, what's less important. And so as you saw in the video, there was a lot of effort through this app to really make it a lot more consistent, to make it branded, and to just have communicate exactly what the sales professionals need to know at a particular point in time to action the key strategies of the company. So this is where the app really became very, very helpful to us because it's one channel. So we're able to work with the different departments and really centralize kind of the communication vehicle and make communications that are relevant, that are extremely timely, that are proper, where the visual language is consistent to the visual language that our external customers see. So there's real alignment in terms of what the customer sees, what our sales staff sees. The content is totally targeted to them. It's actionable, it's in their language, so something that they can immediately take and action. And not only that, they do it on the mobile device. So as you saw also in the message, there's a big push at Tiffany to put a lot of things on the iPad. It makes the interaction with the customer a lot more personable. So we can get the sales professional out of the counter, next to the customer, really much more engaged with them. And the training should be part of that. So they should be able to, between customers, jump in, look at the app, learn something, and then do it as a group. That's another key issue. So the idea, as you see in this image, is that basically we're communicating the same thing to everybody at the same time in a way that can be then communicated back to our customers to make their experience as branded and as consistent as possible.
Delightful as possible, I think is the word I would use for Tiffany & Company. So basically, if you think about a store manager and their role, and everything that they have to do to put on top of that, over 100 emails with no hierarchy, no understanding of what needs to be actioned when, it can be very overwhelming. And I think we could all say probably what happens to 75% of those emails is that they probably never get actioned, opened, or even looked at. So understanding that times have changed, payroll is different, managers' responsibilities are very different. Even at the most high-end luxury of stores, they still have a lot of responsibility that needs to happen. So giving them the tool that they understand what they need to do when to be successful has been a key strategy for both of these organizations, and a successful one. So let's talk about your global presence. So how many stores are utilizing the platform, and in how many languages are you currently publishing it?
So we launched the platform in September to all of our speaking English countries. So we have a total of about 300 stores in 28 different countries. So I would say about half of the stores have the app currently. This year, a big push is going to be to make the content available in 10 different languages, because we are a global organization.
Yeah.
So one of the big challenges is that our messaging needs to reach our sales staff. So while most of our store directors and store managers are English speakers, our sales professionals not necessarily. And then, we need to make the language in the app the same language that they use with the customers. So it's very important that we not only translate but localize our content for our regional audiences.
So when Tiffany & Company is putting out a global corporate message about a new product launch or the quality of their diamonds, that might go to a global audience. But if there's something specific happening in Asia that perhaps is around a celebrity getting engaged, right, that's when the localization comes in and that information from the stakeholder gets published directly to that audience only. So understanding the need to have a global communication but a local one as well helps Tiffany continue the message of continuity and consistency. So the other thing that I find really interesting about Tiffany Company is when we came to you, you already had what we consider a traditional LMS system, web hosted. And how are you utilizing each one of these platforms as a complement?
So we do have a variety of systems that we use for learning. So we have, as Jody mentioned, a traditional learning management system. And if you're familiar with them, they're basically systems used to deploy e-learning courses. So we still use them mostly for compliance-related content, as well as for more in-depth education. So where we have a new hire curriculum and onboarding program, where we do need to take sales professionals off the floor. I haven't really studied the content in depth. We will continue to use our learning management system. We also have a portal, a learning education portal, that contains all of our materials. So at any point in time, sales professionals can go and store directors can go to this portal and find everything related to sales, product, leadership, training, as well as all of our systems training is contained there. So it's a one-stop shop for all the information. And then we just introduced the mobile associate, the communication platform. And this is really a strategic tool for communications and training. So this is really in support of key initiatives that are happening in the moment. So if we have a new product introduction or there's a big marketing push, we will use this app to support that those corporate initiatives on a global basis. And again, to make the content very, very relevant, bite-sized, and fully actionable. So it's really complementing a portfolio of tools.
So just kind of one or two final questions. How does 5th-7th and 5th improve the client in-store experience? When you think of Tiffany & Company, you're already thinking of a very elevated client experience when they walk in the door. So how is this elevating that even further?
So we know that the most important thing for our customers is the experience that they have when they visit our stores. They really, we have a beautiful website where people can go and buy jewelry, and believe it or not, there are some people who actually buy diamond rings or engagement rings online. But when they come to the store, they're really expecting an experience. So what the tool is helping us do is really communicate the key messages that we want sales professionals to have in terms of our brand, our history, our storytelling. But what we want is for them to bring their own personal touch. So take our legacy, take our brand, take all of our wonderful stories around the brand, the jewelry, the beautiful jewelry that we have, and then personalize it and make the experience a personal one. Really connect with your customer and give them a fabulous luxury experience when they visit the store. So this is the key communication platform to help achieve that.
So let's take a quick look into Tiffany's platform and how they are asking their sales professionals to engage their clients.
I've lived in this city my whole life, so I consider myself a local expert. When I find out my clients from out of town, I always inquire about their plans. It's fun to help my clients plan their vacation. I've made dinner reservations for clients, helped them with show tickets, and have made countless restaurant recommendations. I've even had clients make a special trip back to the store to thank me for my suggestions. It's a gratifying feeling to know that I helped to make someone's trip that much more special.
When a client tells me it's their first time at Tiffany, I do everything I can to make sure they have an amazing experience. I remember how special the sales professional made me feel when I made my first purchase, and I want them to feel the same way. I like to give them a personal tour of the store and encourage them to try on anything that catches their eye, no matter what the price. I want them to have fun and feel like royalty.
So after Tiffany & Company launched 57th and 5th, they put out a survey to sales professionals to gather open-ended feedback to see how they were utilizing constructive criticism as well as some very good feedback. So, Pierre, why don't you tell us a little bit about the results that you had from this survey of your sales professionals?
So this is a different way for us to deploy the training. Obviously, it's not only is the content different, we try to make it, as you've seen, very relevant, very short, and very strategic. So one of the things that is different also, it's a mobile platform. So we were a little bit concerned in terms of how we sales professionals are going to use it on the store. And the response we got is that they really enjoyed the fact that they were, that the content was a lot shorter, that they were able to jump in and out, so basically learn something in a few minutes between customers. They really appreciated the fact that they could do this as a team. It's kind of hard to learn something with your coworkers around a desktop computer. It's not really conducive to that. But being able to sit with their managers or between their between their colleagues and review the content and discuss it from the app was really well received. And then they really appreciated the fact that the content is highly branded and in their language. So they take immediate action and immediately. So it's not something that they have to really think about. It's really actionable content that's highly branded. They can use immediately with their customers. And it brings them, it keeps things top of mind in terms of the key messaging that we want to have.
With some questions from you all, so either for myself or for Emily or Pierre or all of us. So does anyone have any questions or anything that we can answer?
Does the app allow you to monitor whether employees have actually been through the content?
So the app is a completely full circle approach. So you're not only deploying content, but you're seeing that it's being participated through results on the back end, live results. So basically, store leaders, regional district managers, as well as corporate, has access to the data. And it could be a survey, an assessment, a picture quiz, a simulation, what do I do in this situation? And then all of those results become visible to parties that can actually move the mark in terms of whether it's coaching and counseling of a specific associate that's in my building, or from a corporate perspective, looking to see where things are trending or where there's opportunity for improvement, which we do see. You know, we see that sometimes there's a question that might have just been misconstrued and everyone's getting it wrong. So we can go in and fix that fairly quickly and address those situations. So, anyone else have any questions or any frustrations on how you guys are currently getting content to your front line? I know video is always a big one, and with this platform, the reason that Tiffany & Company and Kate Spade New York use video as heavily as they do is because of the way that the app allows you to not stream video to the front line, which is a major component. Pierre did a contest where they actually filmed via the bingo machine the live results and was able to push that down to stores. So that I know was something that was really exciting for the field, organic and very internal, but really was a big success.
So it's a communication platform for us. So in this particular case, leadership, we had an incentive program and they were able to do to announce the winners and do a lottery for the stores that made plan, and there were some prizes that were given out, and use the app just to communicate those very successful.
Yeah, and fun. I think that it was very well received. And for Kate Spade New York, obviously video has become kind of a staple for you guys.
Absolutely. I mean, video is really the leading media in communication these days. You know, we used to be storytellers with the written word. We're so reliant now on imagery to tell a story, and really the future is in video. So when developing any training materials, it's really video first and everything else second to support that video. And this platform allows us to easily share our video content with our stores seamlessly and quickly, which is key.
Yeah, it is, definitely. So another thing that I think is really compelling about, especially these two cases, is how branded the app and the experience is, and the fact that you've both chosen to go with a mobile technology as opposed to, you know, back office PC or even POS system. So, why don't you tell us a little bit about kind of the reason you've chosen to use iPad specifically as a mobile solution?
I mean, the ability to use the technology that Multimedia Plus can provide, but really make it a unique and branded experience, to which it seems that Kate Spade completely created this from the ground up, has been pivotal for us. You know, even in naming it the Style Study, it's so unique to our brand. And having a platform on the go that is branded, speaks the brand voice, you know, using that imagery and that color to our internal customer on a platform that they can use on the sales floor. So it's still, if somebody were to take a glance at the iPad and see the Style Study, it would fit right in seamlessly within that store experience. So if there is some downtime on the sales floor, they can easily open up the Style Study, learn a few things, and then a customer comes in and they can put the iPad away. And it's just a really seamless experience.
And we actually do some training on what to do if you're standing doing some of your communication and training program, and a client walks in and is standing there in front of you. And the answer is really simple. Oh, I was just looking at what's coming in next week for fall. It's going to be beautiful. What brings you in today? So all of a sudden, your associate has more information, and they seem very professional, right? They seem that they know what they're talking about, because they do. And now the client has more confidence in what they're going to be experiencing together. And for Tiffany & Company, going to kind of a mobile platform was more than just 57 and 5.
Right. So there's a whole mobility initiative, and again, it's the same kind of the same concept. It's the ability to have everything on the iPad. On the iPad, we have obviously apps that are more functional, like a POS or looking up a particular product, see if there's inventory. But there's client-facing apps as well, so there's the ability to show them a new product, or show them beautiful jewelry. We have a ring sizing app where they can try different combinations of rings. So it can be used not only for the sales professional, but also to, for example, if a client is waiting, you can give them the app and have them look at some of these features. You can use them as a little bit of a distraction or as a way to engage the customer with the brand and with the product.
I can give you just a tiny bit of background on Multimedia Plus if you will give me 2 minutes. As a company, we've been around for over 20 years. We have specialized in retail. We started out as a video production company, working with the world's leading brands, which we continue to do so. I see my other partners back there, who are actually our first on our platform. Can I say who you are? Giorgio Armani. So was the first client to ever be on this platform, probably 10 years ago, maybe a little bit more, So. Basically, we were able to understand very quickly that technology was going to change retail dramatically. But for selfish reasons, we wanted to be able to deliver our beautiful video content that we had, you know, come to build our business on. So we also wanted visibility into understanding what's going on with our video. Is it impacting the intended audience? Is it getting results? We would send out a video and they'd be like, it was really nice. Yeah, it was really nice. Did you do anything with it? Did you get a lift in sales? How many people saw it? Were you just walking by the back room to go to the restroom and just kind of got a glimpse of it, or were you paying attention? So by creating a platform that can deliver the video that we were creating with the full circle approach of the assessment, we were able to get visibility into the ROI of the investment. And from there, we realized there's a lot of stuff that these associates need and managers need to be successful. So we opened the platform and launched the new version, which both of these clients are on, which allowed the publishing to happen. So both Pierre has, you have a team of six departments or eight departments that's publishing? Yeah. So there are about 6 to 8 departments that are now publishing to 57th and 5th. And it's store operations, communications, merchants, product knowledge, a lot of different, yeah, teams. And then Pierre's team is responsible for bringing it to the app and kind of putting the hierarchy in place based on what sales professionals need to be successful at that particular time point. And for Emily, your team is creating majority of the content because you kind of own StopStep.
Yes, yeah, the learning and development team really owns the content from brand training, product training, and guest experience and service training.
Right. So kind of two unique uses, but ultimately it's all about the customers and the experience and ensuring that the associates have all the communications and training they need to be successful. So when you can publish to the tool, that's where we started to really branch out. And now we do things like visual floor sets and product knowledge. We have one of my favorite things that we did for holiday with one of our cosmetic brands, all their executives took their iPhones and literally created holiday cards at their desks. And every week, the associates got a new holiday card from the executive leadership team. So just a really inexpensive, didn't cost them anything more to take their iPhones and film, very organic and very homegrown, which was nice. So we all have iPhones or smartphones, we all can videotape, and you know, utilizing that is a really kind of cool factor, just like Pierre did with his promotional winners of the contest that you ran in stores. So, and that's kind of where we are today as a company, and you know, we have wonderful client partners. We offer not only our platform, but we also offer strategic support to ensure that we get the results that our clients are looking for. So, I think we're good, right? So, thank you all for joining us. I hope you found this informative. And Emily and Pierre, thank you for your partnership.
Thank you.
And we are so lucky to have you as clients.